In fact, gold saved Australia in 1850, and now with the economic downturn in 2009, it's still saving Australia. It's not brains, good planning, infrastructure, or vital export market. It's that same old precious metal, gold. That's why Australians like to say, go for gold. Our story of Australia starts with Macquarie Street. In the foreground, you can see St. Mary's Cathedral, Hyde Park Barracks, and as we look down further, Macquarie Street, we see Sydney Hospital, the first hospital built in Australia, called the Rum Hospital. And further down the left-hand side, you'll see the Australian Club, a men's only club established in 1838. Way down the end of this street, and it's still one of the most beautiful streets in Australia, it's the first street, still the most beautiful, you'll see the Opera House. You only have to walk down this one street, and it's all history of Australia. I want to warn you, this is not Civilization by Kenneth Clark. This is a story of Australia. Further out, looking back and beyond St. Mary's Cathedral, we'll see Sydney Grammar. It was actually the first university, but it's now a preeminent boys' school. Actually, my son goes there. The story of Australia. In the foreground, you'll see St. Mary's Cathedral. You do well here, you get a state funeral there. A little further out is Sydney Grammar. It's the first university. Now it's actually elite or preeminent boys' school. Actually, my son goes here. It's a pretty good place. Hyde Park Barracks across the road. It used to be an asylum and an early prison. In fact, if you look behind me, you'll see Macquarie Street down here. And right at the bottom of that is Sydney Opera House. It's built by a young Danish architect. It's an icon for Australia, but the Australians in their miserable attitude rewarded him by being so nasty to him, he left in disgust with it incomplete. His sons came back to do the refurbishings now. Further along Macquarie Street, which is still actually one of the nicest streets in Australia, you'll see the Rum Hospital, or Sydney Hospital, beautiful building, not much used now. Nearby is the Australian Club. Can you believe it? A gentleman's club, men only, established in 1838. The leader of the opposition is a member of it. They spend all their time, these Anglo-Saxons, trying to keep out Jews and the Irish Catholic, but no one really wants to join the place now. Further along this magnificent street, you'll find the State Parliament buildings. It's still one of the nicest streets in Australia, but remember, this is a story of Australia. It's not Civilization by Kenneth Clark. It's a pretty brute place out here. It's a country trying to establish a civilization amidst droughts, fires that come into the city, and huge droughts. It's man and woman pit against the brute of nature. Only the Irish could have made this country what it is today. And only the Irish had the vigor and the focus and the character to make it the great country that it is. The story of Australia. In the foreground there you see St. Mary's Cathedral. If you die famous out here or make enough money, you get a state funeral there. Further out is Sydney Grammar. It was the first university, then it became a preeminent boys only school. It's actually a very good school, my son goes there. Hyde Park Barracks across the road. That's where they held the early prisoners here. Now further down behind me, you'll see Macquarie Street. It was the first street in Australia, and actually it's still one of the nicest streets. Immediately behind me you'll see the Rum Hospital, or Sydney Hospital. It's a beautiful building, first hospital, but it's empty now. Next to it is State Parliament. Now this is a story of Australia. It's not Civilization by Kenneth Clark. This is a country of huge natural upheavals, brute. It's a country where there's huge famine, huge droughts, floods, huge bushfires while they're trying to build a civilization. There's not a great deal of refinement. In fact, down at the bottom of this Macquarie Street, right here, they built Sydney Opera House. It's an icon of the world. But the Sydney siders rewarded the young Danish architect and were so nasty to him that he left in disgust. Only his sons have come back now for the refurbishing. And also on this street, can you believe it? The Australian Club, a men's only club established in 1838. The leader of the opposition out here is a member of it. They spent, all these Anglo-Saxons spend all their time trying to keep Jews and the Irish out of it. And more recently trying to keep the Asians out. The fact is, no one actually wants to join this silly old club. Anyway, enjoy Macquarie Street, still one of the most beautiful streets in Australia, amidst some of the rubbish that they've built in the outer suburbs of this great city.
The changing face of Australia. RSL clubs are a place where old soldiers can go and have a cheap meal and also some good entertainment.
Now that's a bit of a sick joke. Right next to the internet area where all the backpackers are busy communicating with mum and dad back home or looking to plan their next trip.